Approximately 1 week ago, I made a video about an oscillator that worked between, say, 4 and 7 megahertz. And this is that circuit. And I told about the, say, strange waveform. That waveform looked a little bit like this. All kinds of, say, small sine wave-like aberrations on that waveform. And the idea was, my idea was to make that better and go to a sine wave that had a better waveform. And that's here. And the whole idea is to connect kind of amplifier stage, kind of buffer stage to that oscillator. And that was made here. I will publish the first video, the link to the first video in the text box. And this is a kind of, say, amplifier. And that amplifier was connected, hooked up via a 1N5 capacitor, so 1500 picofarad, to the first transistor of the oscillator. That's in my earlier video. 2K2 Zener diode, and here is that first transistor, and here we say take out the signal, and it goes through this wire, and then with a 1N5 capacitor into the base of the amplifier. And with this potentiometer, we can set the amplification. I have to say that the voltages to drive this circuit are very critical. I use here a negative voltage and a positive voltage. And here are the values of these voltages now. 6.3 volts, positive, 5.8 volt, sorry, 5.1 volt, negative. And this is the waveform. And at the moment it oscillates on 7.1 megahertz. Without an external capacitor, without a coil, etc. So it's a kind of multivibrator that can reach very high frequencies. And it's kind of compensated in its waveform with the help of this amplifier. That's here. So let's look at the circuit. Here it is. First transistor of the multivibrator, second transistor. Here I have used two capacitors of 470 microfarad. And the reason was that it is a high frequency oscillator, and the wiring here to this voltage supply is quite long. So it has a kind of stabilizing effect on the waveform. How it looks like on the scope. Here that second stage made with the BF199, and here the potentiometer in the emitter lead that sets the amplification. And I will now change the amplification. Change the amplification. You see a change in the frequency and in the amplitude. So the question, is this a stable circuit? No, not at all. But it's experimental, and you can get, say, very, very good results when you do more experiments. So I set it now to the maximum amplification. It's here. That is at the moment, say 15 millivolts out at 7 megahertz. And let's see what happens when we change the voltage to the multivibrator by, say, changing the value of the 1K potentiometer. It's in my earlier circuit. And I want to refer to that. So, change it. Let's see what happens. Maximum frequency 7.1 MHz. Now it goes back 6.8. Waveform is quite pure, 5.8, 5.0, 4.1, and here it stops suddenly when I change the value of that potentiometer. So perhaps it's a good idea to split this potentiometer into a coarse and a fine potentiometer, and furthermore, to get it properly stabilized, a stabilized voltage can help. A constant temperature of the whole circuit can help, etc. But this is a kind of, say, good first idea to make the waveform pure.